Hello everyone, and welcome back to another episode of Let's Play No Man's Sky. This is Captain's Log number 16. We are still in an as yet unnamed solar system, having named the planet we just discovered Smolderacus, because it was a pretty hot planet. We needed some thermal protection to protect us. So we're going to take a look at the other planets in the area. This is one of the next planets that's supposedly closer to the Atlas than previously done. But I want to explore the entire area. So we're going to Pulse Drive to get a quick drop in, scan everything here, find out what we can. And then name this system property. So it'll take a little bit for us to catalog everything as we continue our journey towards the Atlas. Cataloging our journey along the way. We have another reddish planet. And this is in fact... Oh, I haven't said that. Give a scan. See what interesting things we can find. Set her down. We have landed on Udanyug Komai in the Euclid Galaxy, at least as it's termed right now. We will in fact rename it, but it's an acid rain planet and I don't have any biological protection to speak of. So I will be getting underground probably relatively quickly once I grab some initial scans of things that are obviously scannable. Apparently these things can give us health. didn't seem to do much though. So there's a nice little outcropping that we can hide under if we are our toxic raininess gets too toxic and rainy. Okay. We have another one of those Thamium berries there. Hopefully this time I won't mess it up and wow, that's a very large plant. Not that one. But that one. There it is. Already discovered this. What's this? Yes. And we have ourselves some supplies. Look for Bobby Turtling. Turtleton. That's kind of, I might use that, the turtle, or turtling. I can't even pronounce that, we're going to rename that. But we found some technology here. Advanced cooling sigma is already known. What's the sentinel presence here like? Sentinels are minimal. The flora is limited, but the fauna is abundant. I wonder what the fauna lives on if the flora is minimal.
Life support power low. Toxic protection falling.
Plenty of resources over this direction. It looks like might be a cave though. But we have a new technology in our gun, which allows us to do something awesome. I think this is a perfect time to try it out. Boom. So we're now underground. Ugh, that's a hostile creature. give it a quick scan if we can. Managed to kill it. So we have hostile creatures underground. Flip over to the mining beam. What else we got? Lots of discoveries going on in this new area. Already discovered this. So I'm not finding a lot underground. Make a hole. That's the debris I came from. There's my ship. Go back inside. See what else we can find in here really quick before we head out to other avenues like this. That's a gold. That's a gold. Gold is always useful. Not a very big cave. Yep, not much of a cave at all. Insect eater. Oh, yeah. But a little glowing bugs floating around. We could use a little carbon. I know we're running low. Here, back. Let's just do this. There we go. I got plenty of carbon. Alright. A couple of things need to happen. On the multi-tool, how do we reload grenades? Charge this up with some thamium, which we can find in space quite abundantly. We'll go ahead and send the carbon to the ship. Didn't mean to do that. Thamium stacked up on the ship. Iron more or less fully stacked on the ship. Titanium, do we got any? Nope. How are we doing on plutonium? We should have plenty of juice for the takeoff thing now. What is this? Is that a gigantic... Well, I saw a knowledge stone down there too. Knowledge stone over there, a gigantic green something or other. Could be gold. Got the Korvax word for units. some new vegetation. Including some animals. Man. That is huge. There's flying things. This planet is crazy. Yeah, that might be emerald. It is emerald. Okay. That's gonna be worth a chunk of cash. Now you guys don't mind if I just strip mine this emerald, do you? Floating make float plant. I mean, as long as the sentinels aren't gonna bug me, emerald is, I think, one of the most valuable resources. One of the most valuable neutral resources. Let me check, in fact, I can find out. Emerald, yeah, it's one of the most complicated. I'm sure they're more valuable rares, but... Yeah, this looks... Well said, Kent. Look, this huge hole was here when I got here, okay? I don't know what you're talking about. Every last drop. Mine. Also. Hiya, Sentinel. How's it going? Look over here and talk to... Wah. There are some crazy animals on this planet. I have learned the Korvax word from language. I love the fact that there's just these slowly flying things. Man, what a cool planet, though. And like, yeah, that's right. So Kent says there's lots of life for a toxic planet. I think it's safe to say that it's only toxic to us, not to the life here, obviously. Oh, hello. Hey, little stuff. Okay. So we have toxic rain, and it is raining on us in a big way. We will have to get in our ship and wait this storm out. Lots of stuff. Well, while we're waiting, we can go ahead and see about making some stuff. Need more plutonium for that? Do I not have much on my person? Oh. I guess I just haven't harvested all that much plutonium. Here, so throw some stainium at this thing. Got a pulse engine charged up. So while we're sitting in here bored, might as well just... Burn. Can't believe that's all the plutonium we have right now. Have a huge stash of iron. So I don't need to worry about picking up any more of that. That's for sure. All we got was 36 units of emerald out of that whole thing. Christian Hubs, welcome back. Yeah, I got a. So here's the ship I got. I bought it from a trader. He sold it. Sold it to me for $200. It was 650,000 units. We ended up having to spend on this thing, but it was worth it because I mean it has a fair number more spots. And we'll do naming at the end of the episode, or after the end of the episode. But yeah, it has a fair number of spots. Okay, so we picked up some plutonium, which is what we needed to continue this crafting process. Warp cell. Plug it in there. I'm going to keep going as long as I have the units, the stuff for it.
Weather update. Storm clearing.
All right, the storm is clearing. Let's go ahead and... Whoa. Didn't necessarily need to launch up that high. Yes, a monolith. Any knowledge stones around here? Doesn't look like it. All right. Captain's log 16.1. Brilliant light erupts from the ancient marker and encircles me, engulfing my mind with the memories and voices of the Korvax echoes. The dreams of entities who once worshipped here became my own. For countless generations, the entities of the Korvax disconnected and passed on into the echoes naturally. Each disconnection added to the knowledge and soul of the convergence. Our home was Korvax Prime. Within its foundations, we stored the memories of our race, an ever-evolving equation that defines us. And with that, I was able to learn more about the Korvax and the language. In this case, I learned the word for brain. My mining beam needs some juice. And while we're here...
Technology recharge.
We'll get our bolt caster filled up too. What else is in the vicinity? I think that's actually going to do us pretty good for this guy. Let's go explore the other planet in the system. Some sort of marker here on this planet. I don't know what it is. It's not really identifying itself. Is it just a gray planet of some kind? What is it? Was a marker. There's gonna be one now. All right, back out we go to this place.
Weather update.
Kent says that this is cool. It's the most info he's on the quarterbacks he's seen in a Let's Play. I've been actually kind of fortunate through dumb luck. You know, it's kind of random. But I've been finding mostly quarterbacks planets, or systems, I should say, in my journeys. I started off on a Gek world, but... And I saw one other Gek world, I know for sure, but it's been a lot of Korvax systems. This thing is a ways away. Abu Gording Ivka. So remember that last planet was toxic and rainy and toxic. And also red. Start thinking about names for things. Some oceans. I think I might want to land close to one of the waterfronts here, so I can check out both the land dwelling and ocean dwelling stuff. See a nice little beach we could land on, maybe right about here. Somewhere around here, like here. Find out what that is. We're on a charred planet, which is a heated atmosphere, low security drones, deficient flora, and medium fauna. So, the fauna that lives here probably does so off of thermal energy. This is a hunting creature. Be careful of that. It's a pretty good sized one too. We're being menaced. Well, the water is cool enough, even though the atmosphere is hot as heck. So we can trade off oxygen for being hot. I'm not seeing any fish in here, or fish. Any swimming creatures whatsoever at this point. There we go. Temperature levels stabilizing. Units received. Now, let us find out what this, where'd it go? That. Is made of. This is something I haven't seen before. Aluminium. which isn't the most important thing in the world. But, you know, we'll pick it up and sell it. I'm not going to mine this whole thing out. That would take too long and be entirely too boring for a live stream. And for, well, not necessarily for a live stream if I wasn't recording an episode, but it's definitely too boring for an episode. So we'll just grab some and go. What else do we have in the area? Anything? Did we already grab this technology? What's that? An unconcerned alpha. This planet also has interesting creatures. And the occasional floating island. See something running around down here. It is a... It is a one of those. Need to grab some more plutonium. I'm not seeing any particularly awesome points of interest. So I guess we're gonna go fly somewhere. Scan along the way. Ah, here we go. Set ourselves down and come pay a visit. To this plant. No, I did actually get that technology unit. That was the one that I grabbed. That technology unit, on the other hand. Impact Sigma already known. Stock on plutonium. Oops, I thought that was plutonium. I thought that was plutonium. Stupid cough. You can go away now. Send that over to the ship. Send that to the ship. Do we have gold on board already? Nope. Do we have zinc on board already? Nope. Plenty of things to scan around here. Man, there's a Corvax inside that we can talk to. Sure, why not? Money. Technology. Beam coolant system theta. And Captain's Log 16.2. The facility is more like a science lab than an observatory. Stargazing equipment sitting amidst the sea of advanced equipment, of advanced experiments. Perhaps the former custodian was too preoccupied to notice the beacon blinking invitingly on screen. If you can work out the code, if I can work out the code, I'm sure I can decipher its origin. 6436. There is another ruin in the area, which will be helpful to find. As soon as I talk to this Corvax, chemist entity Craw. Something something Corvax Convergence, something something and Traveler, something something Atlas, please, please. Captain's Log 16.3, the electronic lifeform is excited. It chitters animatedly and thrusts its holographic datapad towards my visor. It's looking for a confirmation. A symbol appears. A mysterious diamond shape. Its red central orb is likely an eternally unblinking eye. I will show knowledge of the symbol because having, wait, I don't know. I haven't actually seen the symbol. I mean, I know it from the game cover. Oh, bummer. I should have shown it. I should have acknowledged it. I'm low on carbon. Is there a plant in here? Come here, plant. So I pick some plant, get some food. Met 20 aliens. This is a new milestone unlocked. Really? I need 6 more carbon to talk to him. Where's the outdoor? There it is. Carbon, carbon, carbon. I need to shoot some carbon. Give me carbon today. Iron. I'm gonna go talk to this guy. I really want to talk to this guy again. There we go. Corvax Convergence, something Fascinator Traveler. Something Corvax, something something. My presence has made the lifeform somewhat curious. It buzzes faintly to indicate it is open to non-electronic communication. I will request a new word. That is always, always, always useful. I have learned the Corvax word for tissue. Grab a little free plutonium, and then we'll go ahead and get ourselves some stuff. I don't have room for any of that stuff. Well, we're going to save here, and this is where we're going to wrap up episode number 16. Tune in to episode number 17 when we depart to the next star system. But if you're here live, stick around. We have a couple of things to do a naming on, so I can use them in my next captain's log. Yeah, hang tight for that.